welcome to another episode of Drilling Deeper. My name is Christina, and today we're going to look at one of these artifacts right here with me. Today we're going to look at this, and if you look all the way up, you will see that this is a street light. This street light dates from 1862, and it was one of the street lights that lined the main street here in Oil Springs. Now you may be asking, what's so significant about a street light, especially one of this age? Well, you have to think back, 1862, Oil Springs was booming, and it was a rural town in the middle of the wilderness. So this street light was one of the modern marvels that showed the wealth of the community. This was something people didn't see every day. You might have seen a street light in London, Paris, maybe even Chicago or New York, but you didn't see street lights in rural communities. This was something that only the wealthy could afford and prosperous communities. More than that, at this period of time in the 1860s, people, when it got dark at night, went to bed. It was not safe to be out at night. Lamps often blew out, and you just didn't want to waste money on those things. When it got dark at night, you went inside, you locked your doors, and you went to bed. And this is because fuel was expensive. And it was not safe. If it was dark at night and you were in a rural community, you didn't know if there was an animal that would jump out and attack you looking for an easy supper. Or if you were in town or in a city, if you would get mugged and somebody would steal your purse and you might get beat up. These are things that people really did worry about because they didn't have the modern conveniences that we have today. So light at night really is one of these modern marvels. And for a little town like Oil Springs, this was something to behold. One of the historians of the time, Victor Lauriston, remarked that this was one of the modern marvels of the world, one of those modern wonders, because you didn't see it anywhere else. So let's go a little bit further back and to see how technologically advanced this streetlight is compared to things of its predecessors. So back in 1846, Abraham Gessner was a geologist and a scientist in Nova Scotia, and he developed this new revolutionary illuminating fluid called kerosene. He was able to refine it from coal oil, which was plentiful on the East Coast as they have massive coal deposits. By 1858, James Miller Williams had heard about this technological development and had decided to employ it here in Oil Springs, where we have large deposits of crude oil. James Miller Williams dug that first crude oil well that produced 50 barrels a day, and he decided to create the first vertically integrated oil company, the Canadian Oil Company, to harvest crude oil and refine it into kerosene and sell it on the open market. In fact, he was trading it on the New York Stock Exchange that time period as well. And kerosene was revolutionary. It was cheap, it was bright, it burned cleaner, and it was a cheaper alternative to the regular fuel source at that time, which was whale oil. And whale oil is derived from the fat and blubber of a whale. So we can safely say that the development of kerosene from the oil fields of Oil Springs played significantly in saving the whales. You no longer needed to hunt and kill a whale just to provide light at night. So this development happened, and every night in Oil Springs, two gentlemen, Mr. Walsh and Mr. Collins, would use this ladder to climb up to the top of the lamp. The reason why they needed to climb all the way to the top is we suspect that this oil lamp, based on some of the people that we have talked to, opens from the top and you would have to light it from the top with a long wick. And this is because the globe is very thick and heavy glass, so it would not blow out in the winds or in the winter. And we can't see any way for it to open from the bottom or for the globe to lift up. So we suspect that they would have had to open it from the top to light it. And we've talked to several lamp experts and they suspect that's the way it was done. We are going to further investigate this street light when we take it down for cataloging and some refurbishments later this year. So if you have any questions or concerns, feel free to drop us a line, follow us on all our social media channels, and I invite you to, you know, let us know if you have any questions or concerns or other future topics you would like us to discuss. This has been a little bit of Drilling Deeper with Christina, and I hope to hear from you soon. Like and subscribe to our channel.